It's been a big month at recruiting, trying to build those relationships everywhere. We've been all over the place, but I'm just happy to get back this week and get back with the players. So it's been good, getting back, get going with football stuff, right, which is everybody's excited about. So appreciate y'all being here, and anybody got any questions, just let me know.
I'd like to know how your dad thought about
you know, I don't agree with that. A lot of those guys were already, they were already in the portal, before I got offered this job or started getting opportunity to get this job. So, they had aspirations of, playing at a high level and playing in the NFL. And when it comes down to it, kids got to do what's best for them, So, I always tell the kids, I always have great relationships with my players. I feel like that's one thing I've always done as a coach and as a person. Is, hey man, I love you. I want you to, do what you think is best for you, and I'm gonna support you no matter what. It's always our job as coaches, to recruit great players, right? And have guys that, if a kid does leave, you got guys behind them that are just as good, and that creates competition, right? So, I think that's one thing as a coach I've always done is create that competition, right, and have a bunch of good players with the way it is now in college football.
Hey, what's your biggest challenge that you foresee being the transition of your offense from the FCS to the Power 5 ACC and what Pitt will face in a lot of their opponents?
I think the biggest thing is it starts up front. I think obviously the line of scrimmage. Skilled players to me are skilled players. Guys that can run, catch, create big plays, right? I think that's the difference between, smaller levels than the bigger levels is, you have to build a win the line of scrimmage. Two ways to do that, in my opinion, is first way is to play really fast, right? Get guys, playing against some, guys that are really good up front. So you got to, create with tempo and get guys tired and get guys to think a little bit to where they can't play as fast. And you got to recruit really good players, right, up front to where you can dominate line of scrimmage. Because, if you got skilled players and you got a quarterback, you can go have a lot of success. But everything we do, is it's a lot of the best offenses, I believe, in Power 5. We do a lot of same similar stuff that they do. And I think, systematically, I think what we do will translate to any level. It's all about knowing who your players are, putting them in a great position to be successful, and understand their strengths and weaknesses. And that's what we're going to try to do during the spring and the summer is say, hey, who are our best players? What do they do well? What do they do not do well? How do we hide it? How do we hide their weaknesses? And I'll put them in a position to be successful.
What do you bring this Pitt offense?
What do I bring? I think confidence. I'm a confident guy. I believe in myself. I've always had a chip on my shoulder, it's just who I am. I've played small school ball, wanted to be the best quarterback in the country when I played. I want to be the best offense coordinator and coach and a mentor I can be in the country. That's my goal every day. So I think I'm going to bring confidence and just bring an understanding of kids and relationships. I believe that, if I can get a kid to believe in their self first, right, and what they do well, we can find a way to use them and get them in position to be successful. So those are two things I think I'll bring here to Pitt. First thing is Coach Deuce. I've always looked from afar. I've always liked Pitt, the colors and the tradition, man. Growing up, my dad being a former quarterback, he backed up Dan Marino, when he got drafted by the Dolphins. They used to play some funny games after practice, try to hit the goalposts and all that stuff. So, but just knowing that, you can win here, and he's won the ACC championship here. And, it's a place where you can go win. And went at a high level, and obviously, this place is a proven place where you can get players. If you want to have a great offense or a great team and have a chance to go win every year, here you can get players here at Pitt. There's tradition, there's a great culture, and I think that's what really excites me about this place. And obviously to me, the other thing is the leadership from the top. The one thing I really learned here when I interviewed here was that everybody's on the same page here. There's a standard here from top down, from Heather and all the way down to Coach Dew. So I think, that's what's going to, really get me fired up and get me excited about being here.
How do you feel footage of process
You know, it was probably the most stressful time of your life, really. You know, Coach is a very thorough guy. You know, he does a lot of research, man, and I think that's why he's had so much success is he's gonna know everything about you before he pulls that trigger and hires you. And you know, got a phone call, got obviously a big Zoom meeting with people for a long time, and then you know, got to come in as a 24-hour thing and really just get drilled for, you know, a whole day, you know, about football and about who you are and meeting different people and how you handle adversity and how you handle people. You know, I think that's what was great about the interview process here is that you don't just find out about who you are as a football coach. You find out, I think, who you are as a person. And to me, Coach Deuce is the type of guy who that's what he cares about. He wants to be around good people first. And I think that's what we have here. We have good people.
How do you view your current situation at quarterback?
How do I feel it?
How do you view it?
Oh, view it? I mean, Nate's the guy right now. You know, going to spring, I mean, I thought he played really well watching the film the last two games of the season. You know, he's going to have the opportunity to go out there with the ones, and it's his job to lose. You know, he's been awesome since I've gotten here. You know, he's very cerebral. He's been a great leader. He's actually becoming more vocal than he has, I heard, in the past. He's really taking control. And then, hey, you know, we're going to have competition behind him. You know, when it comes down to it, I'm real big on getting everybody reps. I think that matters. You obviously got to get him a bunch of reps. Your quarterback is the biggest part of an offense, right? If you got a good quarterback and he can go play, you can go have a lot of success, right? So we got to build a system around him and what he does well. And then, obviously, you know, when other guys are in there, I got to find out what they do well, too. Because he's really the only one besides Christian that has some game film. So, you know, the other young guys that we have that are here, we got to find out from practice and stuff what they do well and try to put them in position to practice, see how they can grow and develop.
What's the most personal question?
Most personal question. I think for him, you know, being his father being a coach, you know, how is it playing and coaching for your dad? You know, that's always a funny topic, you know, because he played for his dad, and I got to play for mine for 4 years, which was rough. so rough that, you know, after 2 years of playing, my dad hired a quarterback coach because I guess we butted heads a lot because we're a lot alike. We're very competitive. But you know, I thought that was a really personal question just because, you know, he's went through the same situation playing for his dad, right? And his dad was a coach, and I think that was an awesome connection, you know, because he knows what it feels like to be a coach's son and to be – you know, I think the biggest thing that was the best learning for experience for me when I was young was not just playing for my dad, but living with the players and see how they view him as a head coach. I think that gave me a great perspective on what kids think about their coaches and things they do well and what they don't do well. And, you know, I got to experience that as a college player, which was, I think, was awesome. Yeah.
How do you put into words what it means to you to be the offensive coordinator of this team?
Oh, it means everything. It's literally, yeah, I feel like I'm put on this earth to do. You know, I love the game. You know, I love football. I want to be the best at it. You know, that's kind of who I am every day. I'm kind of choking up a little bit because, you know, my dad and just, you know, he believed in me young when I was 24 years old. I was a GA. It's kind of crazy. I don't know why I'm crying, Coach. But you know, you're 24 years old and you're a GA, and next thing you know, he's telling you halfway through the season, hey, man, I want you to go to box and call the plays. I think you're ready. And, you know, a lot of coaches think he's crazy, you know. And you know, when people believe in you, you know, Coach Deuce believes in me. And I think that means something, you know. So I'm excited. The best thing that happened, I think, is Coach Dew's a very open person. You know, he wants you to be honest. You know, he doesn't care if you believe different than him. You know, he likes to argue, which I like. he always has an opinion, and I do too. I think that's why we get along. But, you know, I got to sit in every interview with him and us kind of bounce ideas and kind of what, you know, what he wants as the head coach and what I need to be successful. And when it comes down to it, what's best for Pitt and what's best for us as a whole team to go compete and you know, compete in the ACC and win. right? And I think that was the best part about it is that, you know, I got to see what he wanted and what his vision was, and then how do we put the best pieces together? And I thought he did that as a head coach. You know, we, you know, I think the way we're all a little different in what we do well and what we don't do well, I think we fit really well together. So I'm excited about our side of the ball. Disagreements? We don't really have much disagreements. You know, I'm going to be honest with you. You know, Coach wants to win and he wants to score points. You know, and however we got to do that, that's what we're going to do. You know, I think that's football's that simple. You know, what do we got to do to be successful? You know, he's been awesome, man. I mean, he's been very open. He listens. I think that's what makes him a great head coach. You know, he's been through it. He's been here for a long time, and it's, you don't see that in college football, and there's a reason why, because he knows what he's doing, and he knows how to win, and he's been successful everywhere he's been, and so I think that's what makes, you know, this place where it's at right now is you know, we're in a situation where we know what we need to do to go do it, and we just got to put the work in.
Hey, when you have an offense that's built on playing and scoring fast, how does the running game complement everything you want to do within the passing game?
Yeah, I think the first thing is, you know, everyone probably say I like to throw it around a lot, right? Which I do. Any quarterback, you know, likes to throw the ball. But to me, when I became offense coordinator, I was really big on, you know, running the football. You know, when we were at Valdosta State that year in 18, when I was really, you know, after 17, when I became the offense coordinator in 18, I took it over full time. You know, if you look at us there, we ran for, you know, 260, threw for 260. We were the most balanced team probably in history of college football. To me, the run game, you want to build everything off the run game. If you can run the football, if you can find ways to have sex in the run game, it makes throwing the ball easy, right? Now, next thing you know, you're getting more two-man, you know, one-man box or one high safeties, and you can push the ball down the field and create matchups and get guys open. So, to me, man, you know, when it comes down to it, whatever we got to do to score points. You know, we might run for hopefully over 200 yards one game, and next game we might throw for 300, 400, right? Whatever we got to do to win and score points. And I think, you know, I want to have a great balanced offense that can do both. You know, obviously, I think the biggest thing is like you said, just kind of see them and the way they move around and see how they fit. You know, I'm really big on you're not just a receiver. You're not just a tight end. You're not just like a running back, right? Like what position do you fit in at receiver? Are you an X? Are you whatever, right? Like, are you outside guy? Like, where do I need to put you for your skill set to flourish, right? And so I think that's the first thing to, you know, to when you're evaluating the former offense, right, is okay, what position did they put those kids in the last couple years, and was that good for them or not good for them, and then how can we find a way to put them in a better position to be successful? So that's kind of what I'm doing right now, trying to get all that figured out.
We talked to you before, said that they had the upper hand because they had the playbook already, the ones who came with you. Is there kind of a comfort for you to have them here, knowing that they're helping the new guys with all the changes and everything?
Yeah, so, you know, I got here and we were out recruiting and we were, you know, I've been gone every day during the week, you know, for the last month. So really what was awesome with those guys is that they were able to get those guys and go do things, right? Talk about the installs, talk about the offense, get them to understand exactly where to line up, what we're trying to get accomplished with everything we're trying to do with tempo, right? And just getting them to understand the base of it and getting them ahead, right? So when we get back, you know, we'll have some time to then get going, right, with offense. So it just kind of, to me, it helps a lot because, you know, during this time, we can't be with them all the time, right? And so now you got guys who they can go to their, you know, apartment and they can sit down and talk about the offense and kids that want to learn, that really want to play, you know, they'll do that. And I think it keeps us ahead and it kind of gets us ahead going in the spring ball. Yeah, so when it comes down to it, you know, we're going to go fast when it's time to go fast. You know, we're going to be able to do everything as fast as we want to do it. The way I built the system the last 5 years, you know, create my own system and kind of I want to be able to go. If I want to go as fast as Tennessee, I can. Right. We have the ability to do that, but also have the ability to have, you know, illusion of that and, you know, then get into really good plays and help guys have success and get them open. you know. So I think it depends on the game. You know, some games we might snap it 60 to 70 times. Another game we might snap it 85 times. It just depends on the matchup and what we think is best for us to go score and win the game. So, you know, I want to have the ability to do both, you know, if, and whatever we need to win, go win the game. Quarterback mobility? I don't think it matters. I know people would probably think that because we're a tempo and we spread around, but to me, you know, I feel like the way the system is, you know, you give me Tom Brady, I think we can have and go win with him, right? You give me Lamar Jackson, I can go win with him, right? I tried to build, once the guy's the starter, I'm going to build the system around who the starting quarterback is. It ain't about me. I don't have no ego. I've already played. I went through college. You know, I'm going to, hey, this is what we do well. This is what the quarterback does well. Okay, how do we put him in a position to be successful? How do we make his job easier? And that's just kind of how the offense fits. You know, the offense is probably going to look different every year, depending on who's behind center, right? And I think that's what, you know, I think is what's great about the offense.
How has Coach Underwood helped your transition?
Oh, he's been awesome. You know, Coach Wood, being a former NFL player, you know, like I said, this is an NFL system from the base. And it's built to where we can go really fast. So he understands the concepts. He understands what we're trying to get accomplished. One thing about Coach Wood is he has great relationships with the players. You can see that. Kids smile when they see him. He has great energy. And so, you know, that's been awesome with him, just, you know, obviously having a relationship with him and just seeing the way he has relationships the same way that I want my players to view me, right, and our players here to view me. And so he's been awesome in that part. Yep.
Obviously, those guys don't always want to go as fast as you're talking about going. They want you to keep their defense on the sideline. Mm-hmm. As you were explaining it, Pat, explaining your offense, did you see him squirm a little bit, or did it seem like that's the kind of thing he was looking for, something a little more explosive, a little faster, like you were talking about?
He told me he wanted to go score points and go fast and score points. You know, I'm going to be honest with you. I don't think I'd be here right now if that's not what he wanted. Just makes sense because, that's, you know, that's not how it really has been. And that's just being honest, you know. You know, and I think that's what shows that he's willing to, you know, try something new and change. And the way college football is going is, you know, I tell our kids all the time, we could be up 21, and like that in college football, you can be down 7, right? And so if you're not trying to separate from people, if you're just trying to barely win, right, if you're not trying to, you know, be a, you know, have confidence and be aggressive and try to, you know, step on people's necks, as I would say, right, you know, bad things can sometimes happen, right? And so, you know, and it's awesome. I think he's a super aggressive guy. You know, he wants to win, and I think that's all that matters. Oh man, you know, I'm excited about him. I think he's gonna have a great year this year. And the reason I say that is that we're gonna be able to move him all around the field. You know, he's gonna be lined up in all positions. He's not just going to be in the backfield on the line of scrimmage. He's going to be lining up everywhere. And I think what that's going to do is create matchups for us, right, and seeing how they play him and who they put on him and just using him as a guy who, you know, is a weapon, a guy that he runs good enough down the field. He's athletic. We've seen that. Some of the catch and run stuff he's had, right? Getting him the ball in the space. You know, sometimes just throwing him the ball out there, and even though you got the littler guys blocking, it doesn't matter. He's a big dude that can run. He's going to get you, you know, at least 4 to 5, right? And so that's the type of guy you want to have at that position, a guy who can, you know, be a matchup nightmare. And excited to use him in the red zone, too. I think that's a big, big part of it, right? And find matchups. So I'm excited about him. Very important. I think that's the hardest. You know, everybody talks about quarterbacks. The offensive line is the hardest position, coach. You know, you got 5 guys on the field at one time. They have to be on a chain with communication and everything going on. They really set the tempo. They set the physicality of the offense, you know, and the nastiness. And just having him to where I don't have to teach that. You know, I have to, you know, having him come in and I can know he can take those guys right now and teach them everything I want them to know and exactly how I want it done. That's huge because to me, that's the one, probably the hardest position to coach. One guy coaching 5.
Kelly, do you have a last question?
I just want to say, you're a fast talker. Coach is a fast talker. When you two are together, like, is there any breathing going on?
you know, I don't really know. I didn't know I was that fast talker. you know, I guess I try to get straight to the point. That's kind of who I am. I'm a straight shooter. You know, I'm like that with the players. I'm honest. I think that that goes a long way. You know, if you're honest from the beginning, you know, you can build that relationship and build that trust. So, you know, I just try to get straight to the point.
Coach, thank you very much.
All right. Appreciate y'all. Thank you. Yes, sir.